Bow. Yes, good bow.
Then I came to meet Elizabeth. She came to my house to tell me about my dog. What I didn't think of is that it had been 15 years since I had a puppy. So there was a lot I didn't know. She left her in the car in a crate, and I'm overprotective, and I just lost my dog. And I'm like, well, where's the dog? Where's the dog? Get the dog. And she's like, Rachael, you're ignorant. And it stopped me in my tracks, did it not? The one thing I cannot abide by, none of us have time right now to be willfully ignorant. It is the worst thing we can do to each other, to our country. However you have to learn to listen, learn to listen. And you did that for me. Ready? Go get it. Do you find that going down the path of working with animals has helped you work with humans better in life?
I found that working with humans have helped me work with animals better.
Wow.
Yeah, definitely.
And I thought it would be the polar opposite, mm-hmm. that animals teach you the empathy or the patience, but really it's the people are more challenging and they help you with challenging dogs?
They come in with more stories. They come in with more stuff. The dogs, when they walk in, you know exactly what you're getting right in front of you.
Gotcha.
So by learning how to work with people and talk and figure out what their goals are and what their challenges are, you know, some people don't come in with a lot of resources. But we just got to figure out how to make it work. Mm. That allows me to help that dog in a much better way.
I get you. Do you always see the same behavior in animals that come from similar circumstance? When you get a rescue dog mm-hmm. versus a dog that's been bred mm-hmm. for a specific breed?
Some dogs, some rescue dogs, just slide into the house like they're Mary Poppins. You know, Christmas dinner, we take a lick from the granny's wine, we play around with the kids, because that's our expectation when we go in and get these dogs. There are some dogs, when they come into that situation, they don't have the resilience and they need way more support.
You've just completed a book. Mm-hmm. What is the soul of that, and what do you want people to get from it? And what do you want people to get from your life's work?
So the book, it's called Building a Balanced Canine, mm-hmm. and it actually reflects so much of what we're talking about. That's a good girl. The beginning of every chapter talks about the human perspective on what they're seeing. And then the dog's voice comes in and explains it from their point of view. So a huge part of the book is about owner education. Learning's not one way. Any information I give to you, you're going to give back something. And that's what a true learning and teaching experience is. Whether you're dealing with a dog, a human, a dolphin, it doesn't matter.
It doesn't matter.
It's two-way. And it needs to be, because then everybody benefits.
Nice job!
Bella Boo Blue. At just under 6 months old, she is about the size Izzy was.
She's about 50 pounds.
Yeah, she's already about 50 pounds.
She's
and this
got
beautiful lady
huge paws.
With her. Look at those reindeer hooves.
There they are. There
she
they are.
Is Elizabeth La Jeunesse. And Elizabeth has come into our life for a variety of reasons, in my opinion. She has literally written a book on dogs. And what I love about Elizabeth is that she brought to our lives a little more order on how humans can speak to each other too.
Yep.
And this is the first time we've ever Zoomed with any of our dogs. You see the reaction we're getting.
Yeah, that's it.
Isabel used to cry if she heard me in a TV screen or in a computer screen because she'd try and go around it and find me.
Sure.
Look, Bella doesn't care.
Bella's like, we're quiet. I'm trying to think now.